What's up? What's up? It's your boy ADNS all day in the spot. Finna talk about this game too. I'm a little disappointed because I was in here making a video and I forgot to pull the speaker cord out. And I hate when I do that because when you don't pull the speaker cord out, you will be in here talking for no reason and y'all will just get a blank screen. So I'm happy I noticed that before it got too late. Damn it, man. But basically what I was talking about in the last video, what I was trying to make was that, yeah, this game, man, crazy. I mean, now they down 2-0, even though I kind of had a slight feeling they may be down 2-0. I kind of did, because they want to switch it up, you know, they want to add the tension. Because as you can see, right now, KD is like doing everything right now. Golden State don't even look like Golden State no more. I mean, you should have seen in the video I was just making that I messed up, man. I accidentally called Golden State the Thunder I don't know how many times, though. Because I realized they are letting Kevin Durant get away with whatever. And right now, the referees are not on the Cavaliers' side. And we know the referees can be on whoever side they want to at any given time. Well, depending on what the plan is. But they wasn't there for the Cavaliers. Because you notice the Cavaliers was complaining more about fouls and calls. Cavaliers' defense was just so horrible. I mean, it makes no sense for these people to be playing basketball this long, be getting paid this much, and y'all make the most simplest mistakes. I mean, y'all defense is horrible. I mean, I just can't believe Kevin Durant can pretty much come out there and do whatever the hell he wants and y'all act like he not good. You know, like when you play basketball in real life, you're going to find out who's the best player on the other team and you're going to try to shut him down. You know, you might leave some other weaker players open, you know, to try to put pressure on the main player, which was Kevin Durant. I wasn't really seeing that. Come on now, this is game two. This is game two. I mean, they was letting Kevin Durant run past them, outrun them. I mean, what was up with all these blocks? Since when did Kevin Durant, oh, he's a beast blocker. I'm just sitting here like, y'all is letting him block these shots. The Cavaliers were playing very weak on purpose, throwing up weak shots, fluky shots on purpose just so they could get blocked. And then they had to make some type of excuse for the Cavaliers to lose, and that was their excuse. That makes no sense how the Warriors was playing such great defense, getting blocks like that, but the Cavaliers are playing stupid as hell. Come on, man. They want you to believe in pressure and all this bull. Like, these people are professionals, okay? They know how to stick defense. Trust me, they letting KD run past them. Trust me. I'm seeing it. I'm seeing them make bad decisions on defense. I'm seeing them, oh, I can stick KD or I can stick him. I'm going to run up and stick the shooter. Let KD run right past me. See, man, that's the only reason why they traded Kevin Durant to Golden State, to add a difference. Because, you know, darn well, if it was Thomas and them all over again, man, people probably wouldn't even be watching pretty much like I don't, you know. I used to come in here and do the full reviews, and now I'm just like, yo, this stuff, man. People gonna probably start paying less and less attention to the NBA, man, because I just don't see it picking back up like how I did with Michael Jordan, because at least back then it was more believable. Now it's like, this is crap, man. People just ain't trying. People not getting back. I mean, I swear that was just a goof. It's like game one was the offense, Cleveland's offense being clumsy as hell. And game two was just the defense just being horrible, man. And how in the world do you let Golden State get that many blocks on you? How? I mean, that stuff made me mad when they were sitting there talking about some Kevin Durant is a great blocker. I'm like, since when? Since when? He doesn't just magically up his game all of a sudden, man. They was letting him block those shots, man. Like I said, they was throwing them layups so weak. Referees wasn't giving Cleveland crap. I mean, I seen some calls out there that was blatant as hell was Golden State, but they'll say, oh, it was Cleveland. See, not only do you got the players acting goofy, not only do you got the rims on some crazy type of mechanics, you also got the damn refs out here just doing what the hell they want to do or obviously playing favoritism. Because like I said, I'm seeing charge calls that ain't right, fouls that ain't fouls. The most disgusting part to me probably was the defense. But now I'm going to talk about like what's going on. So like now they're down 2-0. And I'm like, okay, this is, I had a feeling this could probably happen. But I was thinking 1-1, but I also thought a little bit like maybe they might let them win 2-0 just to get the people going, make them think that Cleveland is unstoppable. I woke up this morning, read an article on Yahoo News, a man just up talking KD and Curry, man, up talking them big time, man. Like they out there unstoppable, basically. That's how they was talking about them. I noticed in this game they was trying to keep it a little closer. But I feel like the plan was still for them to lose. But again, they didn't want them to drift off too far because people would have started changing the channel. So they had to make it a little bit closer. You know, LeBron got a triple-double or whatever. You know, make it seem like something happened. But you see the team's defense was very, very off today. I mean, I can't even believe these professional players who've been playing this long can't even stick correct defense. I swear, it make me not even want to watch. I swear, because I'm like, can I please see a real game? Can I please see these people really go at it and compete? Why do I keep seeing them let people go past them? Why do I keep seeing the Cavaliers making the Golden State defense look amazing while their defense is just lazy? I mean, not even getting back. I'm like, oh my goodness, like, get out of here. LeBron James should be the one out here blocking all these shots. Come on now. It was situations where I seen LeBron could easily block people and was not blocking them. It was times when Curry, I couldn't even believe Curry was getting in front of him like that. And it was time where LeBron was backtracking Curry. Easily could have got the behind black, a block. Easily wasn't doing it. I'm like, see, this some bull. I'm like, see, man, game three, it might be the reverse, man. Now, this is the most important game right here so far because, yeah, man, because if Cleveland lose this game, man, I think Golden State might do the sweep, which might be some unseen crap. But at the same time, look how much hype is still on that side. And we still know that LeBron James is like considered to be the bad guy of the league. And it's always crazy when the bad guy wins. Kind of like in the WWE. Don't it just blow your head off when the heel wins and you don't want them to win and then they win? I don't know, man. That game was so ugly defensively for Cleveland and Golden State. Everything about it. It's just crap to me, man. I can't even believe so many people are still watching these games, man. I mean, especially seeing the same two teams play each other. I'm like, wow. I'm like, well, what's the dealio? Like, what's the deal, you know? Let me know what y'all think, man. Let me know, do y'all think Cleveland might come back in the next game? Let me know. I think so, though. I really do. I really am thinking like, nah. I don't think they will let Cleveland win this game. I don't think they'll make it go 3-0. Now, that'd be some real craziness if they made it go 3-0 and then somehow magically Cleveland start coming back from 3-0. I don't think a team has ever done that, right? I don't think so. And actually won from 3-0. Now, what if they did that? You know darn well they'll be thinking King James is King James for real. Because like I said, for some odd reason, it seemed like people think a team is stronger when they come from a behind win than when they actually blow them out. I'm starting to realize that because you know they love to put these lies in your head and these beliefs when you should know the facts. And I'm starting to see that like, yeah, man, they starting to make a strong team be the team that comes back. You know, even though it's common sense, yes, the team that blows you out is the stronger team. But, you know, I just feel like people was going to think that it's way more exciting and there are going to be a way more better team if Cleveland just comes back out of nowhere, just like what they did last year. But last year was a little different, though, because like I said, they had a win by now. So, you know they got to switch certain things up. Even though it's the same teams, they got to add little slight twists to the mix, like Kevin Durant. As you can see, if it wasn't for him in this finals series, this series wouldn't even be crap. It really, Golden State wouldn't be doing jack right now, man. I'm serious, man. They starting to make Kevin Durant look like this is his team now, man. I mean, I love Kevin Durant. I loved him when he was on the Thunder, man. I'm not saying he's a bad player. I'm not saying that. But it's just weird how all of a sudden he takes off now when he gets traded to another team. When, in my honest opinion, Kevin Durant played way better when he was with Westbrook. So it just shows you how they just making certain things happen. They just showing you they just want you to believe in whatever they want you to believe. And they don't want you to know who the real winners and losers are, because it's always about that money. And that's why these games have gotten so boring. Like, I'm serious. It's like, I'm watching them, though. But I'm like, golly, these games are fluky. Man, they are acting so phony. Man, they bounce around the court like Gumby. Like, it's ridiculous, man. Fouls everywhere. I mean, even free throw shots that look like they shouldn't be getting missed are getting missed. I'm like, how y'all missing these free throws? You know, just, man, I think this will really enrage a real sports player, because, you know, they try to trick you. You know something else they be doing? I also noticed that how they don't even show certain plays over. You notice that? It's like certain replays, they're quick to show you, but then certain ones, plays where things happen, I'd be like, man, I want to see that again. And they won't even show it to you. They'll hurry up and run the play again. It's like certain things do be happening that be really noticeable, but they don't want to replay that crap. They just want to hurry up, move on to the next play. So tell me what y'all think, man. Because, man, oh, man. You know, I'm going to watch the next game, but oh, my God. This is just, man, that defense was so horrible, man. Man, I think a high school college team could beat them with that type of defense. I ain't even playing, man. I think a college team could beat the Cavaliers playing like that. I mean, that defense was whack. Who is calling these plays? Who? Alright, man. Like this video, comment. Tell me what y'all think. I know it's crazy what we're seeing down 2-0. I know it is. But tell me where y'all think this is going to go. Because I think it's going to be a whole different story when Cleveland gets back to Cleveland. You know how that crowd stuff go. You know how it go. But holla at y'all later. Peace out.